pleasure in problem solved. Listen to all the people on the left, if you're down with every breath, help me out, shout it out, oh yeah.
Thank you. You tell us where the closest place to Shred is.
Pardon me?
The closest place to Shred.
Shred what?
Shred.
I don't know whether you're talking about shredding paper or something else. I've never heard of
our
Shred.
Friend.
Come on up, and let's do it. I got a Rolodex, a Cadillac,
some thousand motherfuckers. What's up? This is Nathan Wessel. We're on a props road trip, North Coast, Northeast Coast. I don't know. Probably go to Tail Tap now. Me daddy going to party with Bacardi, getting loose. You know we
know the crap, don't be in the room, another stuck man. I remember back in the day when I used to not be so busy. I used to pile everybody in a car and just go anywhere we wanted.
So much more out there than just the local skate park. Get some of your friends together, go on a road trip.
I am Joe Cupp, part owner Section 8, and I'm from Youngstown, Ohio.
I met Joe at a Rampage contest in 94. We've been good friends ever since. Pretty much asked Joe to come on this trip just to film, but his riding speaks for itself.
Hi, this is Dave Jacob. I like hamsters.
Dave kind of does his own thing. He's got a real unique style. Probably has something to do with how enormous his hands are, or the fact that he's an alien. Dave's always worried about people thinking he's an idiot. Well, he is, other than his cat degree. Just kidding, Dave.
Hey, what's up? My name's Adam Thing Banton.
In 97, Adam was going to give up riding for an education.
Hit the wall, do a slider.
What a ludicrous thought.
Fakey. And I pulled it. All right, cool.
I like hacked up too much. I like migraines.
I love you, Adam.
I got braces. Get over it.
Hi, my name's Drake Miller. I'm from Lakewood, Ohio. Gonna jump through this wet camera.
Drake. Well, he's just a badass. Does whatever he wants, whenever he wants. I look at Drake as more of a street rider.
Hi, my name's Tony Menick. I live in a suburb of Cleveland, Fairview Park, Ohio.
Tony, he's a pretty smooth, dialed rider. He's even dialed enough on the trip that it kept his hernia from blowing out the side of his body until he got surgery after the trip.
Yeah, Tony Menick.
Hey, this is Tony Menick, and this is the Scooter Wall Ride.
Hey, this is Aaron Bostrom. Jumping the spine, no listening. Head fake, going to do this manual. So I'm gonna pull it right now. I'm just picking subs.
Aaron, he's one of the only people I know that goofing around actually makes him more serious about doing something on his bike. It's never a dull moment with Adam and Aaron around. Just dancing around or whatever, it's just non-stop comedy.
The only thing that bummed me out on this trip is I couldn't take my good friend Sean Dorr. The last minute notices, his work schedule, just didn't work out. Sean's always been one of my major influences in riding. I've always looked up to him. No one even knows how unbelievable he is. This is why I'm sincerely sorry that he couldn't go on this trip. This is also why he's getting kidnapped for the next one. Bennett, well, he got kicked off before the trip even started. We let him tag along though to a couple parks. Well, now that we got our crew, we're off on our Northeast Coast adventure. We're gonna ride some trails, session some parks, and hit up the streets. And along the way, hang out with some friends.
Wow, the band's rolling!
Our trip starts off at Greeny Trails and then moves on to downtown Cleveland. Rolling home, sad resentment. Scum that never made, ridiculed and rejected. Faith has been betrayed, cold man. We pray for your mistakes, knowing you'll never know just who we are. Searching for a future. We'll be right back. on our way again to Section 8, Hubbard, Ohio. If you've never ridden a skate park before, this probably isn't the place for you. But if you're a more experienced rider, this is the spot you want to be at. The biggest plus is both owners ride BMX. We left for Erie, Pennsylvania, hometown of Chris Bennett and some pretty amazing locals. We wanted to ride trails, but it had rained the night before, so we ended up going to Shebang Skate Park for the whole day. They have a huge 7-foot spine with a 40-foot ceiling. The only thing getting close to that would be Mike Aiken teaching Bennett how to throw a bike for real.
Thank you.
left in the morning for a skate park called Studio 334 in Indiana, Pennsylvania. Everybody was pretty beat down from the last 3 days, so we woke up with no plans in mind and decided to head for a super mellow day at Woodward. It's pretty cool over the winter. Woodward's got a weekend rate going on, so pretty much anybody can go and ride an indoor heated building. If you want to know any more information about this, just call the number on the screen.
The outcast, the record's up, the memories are done.
Next, we went to an old 70s-style cement skate park with Snake Runs and Bowls in Reading, Pennsylvania. We had a lot of trouble finding it, but finally got there. The best way to find this is just ask local bike shops, and they'll direct you as close as they can. Dark Fest, so we rode Street Next in Philly. We met up with Ben Homan and Derek Adams and a couple guys, and we just rode and had a good time. Seven a.m. comes pretty early when you're rolling up to FDR. If you want to ride, that's the time you gotta go. The new section they added at FDR is amazing. There's like four bowls all hip together and spine. It's really, really good. FDR and we're hungry.
You want cheesesteak?
We stopped by the new Little Devil Pro Shop. Pretty much you go in there, they got everything you needed and everyone. After that we left and went to Villanova University. After the short street session, we decided to go to a mellow skate park session at the Incline Club in Lakewood, New Jersey. Options on our last day, we decided to stop in Bethlehem for one more fun session. Ended up riding a little bit of street and then ended up at Penn Skate.
Tired and solid.
overall, road trips are a lot of fun. You learn a lot about yourself, your friends, and life in general. Pick some good friends, pick a good destination, see what happens.
My name is Ralph Sinisi. I'm 25 years old from Clifton, New Jersey. I don't really know much to say about Clifton. Just a regular town. Regular people. I've been riding for quite some time. I like to ride anything. It doesn't really matter. Mostly street. Usually move from spot to spot and search for new spots. See a lot of interesting things sometimes in your travels. A lot of stuff to check out on the way. Learn a new appreciation for different kinds of architecture. I like riding different cities, especially New York City. Things are always changing. There's always new construction going on here and there, and new construction all over means there's different stuff to ride all the time. You always gotta re-explore and check things out. You know, sometimes it seems like there's nothing new to ride, and sometimes you don't care. Sometimes you just ride a curb, ride whatever. It doesn't really matter. Shoulder comes out pretty easily. Sometimes it's not bad. Sometimes it takes a couple days and you're all right to go back on riding. I don't know. I don't practice in anything. You know, I just I do whatever's around to do. I think that something that you love the most, you have to hate the most, because that's what will get you the maddest, is the thing that you know you care the most about. Crashing. I'm getting sick of crashing. I've been crashing too much lately. I'm always getting hurt. I'm getting sick of the weather conditions. Winters are getting harder to deal with. I need a drink. I'm getting a bit parched. Stop laughing. But starting Animal, I wanted to start something that was a bike company more based on bike riding and less on the, you know, bike industry. Try to spread some new ideas, you know, maybe in bike riding. I don't know. There's a lot of, you know, a lot of good riders out there that people don't really see or hear about. I decided to put most of them onto Animal. Bike riding to me has never been something that's, you know, something good to do, you know. It's always been like escape, so it's getting away from things that you have to do.
Trust me, I'm a doctor.
You don't get scholarships for bike riding, or people never come out and cheer for you while you're, you know, scratching up their property, or it's not any kind of a sport. It's definitely weird. People talk about it like that. A lot of different places try putting spikes on rails and stuff to try to get you to stop riding over there, and you know, sometimes you just gotta, you know, you could just cut them off, or sometimes just go right over them if you can, or you know, make the best of any situation that you have. History of sponsors, huh? Base Brooklyn started giving me clothes, then Steve Crandall gave me a frame. FBM was my second sponsor. I ride for Intense Energy, skateboard and bicycle shop. Bike riding. I don't know, I guess because it's important, you know, it gets me really pissed off. My bike's been feeling like the biggest piece of shit all the time lately. It's always messed up. Sometimes I just want to take it and smash it with a sledgehammer.
Get the rock out of the road.
Gets me pretty pissed off.
No, seriously, I don't want to ride anymore. I quit.
I'm not going to stop riding. You know, no matter what, I don't think I could ever stop, because then it would be like having nothing, you know, almost, you know, it would be such a big thing, it would be, I couldn't see life without it.
style is as important as anything else. If you don't have style, normally your tricks look gross and not a lot of people are going to like you.
Riding has never really helped me pick up any girls.
Mm-hmm. I've yet to meet a girl that is really impressed. I don't think I crash that much, you know. I don't consider myself sketchy.
Jason Ans.
I'm Ron Kimmler.
This is John Heaton.
Jim Slinsky.
Colin Winkleman.
Dave Primeth.
My name is Van Homan.
I'm Dave Asato.
Joe Tizio.
Louis Anthony Caparelli.
Dennis, take her on the car and show her what's up.
Dennis.
Hi, this is Dave Jacob. Nate said if I pulled this turn, I wouldn't have to do it again. All right, I'm gonna try two more trips. I'm gonna try fucking. I'm gonna try spending first. I'm going nuts.
Oh, look.
I really didn't want to bite you.
All made up. All better.